The Office of Civil Defense says it is closely monitoring parts of Luzon and the Visayas that will be affected by Amang. The agency adds they are all hands on deck for the country's first tropical cyclone this year.
Tayo po, patuloy po na nagpre-prepare kita po sa pag yung tumadaan po ngayon at ating mga assets po, manpower at mga relief items. Ay ngayon po ay naka-preposition, well-prepared sakaling kailanganin po agad. Mga rescuers, mga doktor, at iba pa pong emergency workers ay mga naka-standby na po, no? So wala pong nag-break. Lahat po ng mga emergency workers po natin ay ating mga pinapasok at naka-standby po.
Tropical Depression Amang unleashes strong winds and intermittent rains in the province of Catanduanes. But local disaster management officials say the situation in the province has started to improve. They add the local government remains on alert for possible landslides. Signal number one is still raised over Catanduanes.
Lahat naman po ng area sa Catanduanes ay susceptible sa landslide. Although hindi na katulad nung panahon na talagang konting ulan na talagang naglalandslide. Sa ngayon po, medyo nagkaroon na ng stability. In 2 years na situation namin dito, nabawasan na po yung nasa monsoon season tayo, yung northeast monsoon, nabawasan na yung mga landslide.
Let's now get the latest on the movement of the storm. We have on the line PAGASA forecaster Veronica Torres. Veronica?
Hi, good afternoon and all of our audience. So this is the latest with regards to Tropical Depression Amang. The center of TD Amang was estimated based on all available data in the vicinity of Lagonoy, Camarines Sur, with maximum sustained winds of 45 kilometers per hour near the center and gustiness up to 55 kilometers per hour. It's currently moving northwestward slowly. And because of Tropical Depression Amang, we have raised signal number 1 over Catanduanes in some areas of Sorsogon, Albay, Camarines Sur, Camarines Norte, some areas of Laguna, Aurora, and some other areas in Quezon, including Polillo Islands, other areas in Rizal, Bulacan, and Nueva Ecija. And as of now, areas under signal number 1 may experience strong winds associated with the tropical depression, which may cause minimal to minor impacts to life and safety. And that's the latest from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center, Veronica Torres.
Veronica, thanks.
In other news, former Quezon City Mayor Herbert Bautista sued for graft by the ombudsman over allegedly anomalous projects in 2019. Bautista and former QC Administrator Aldrin Cunha were named in the complaints filed before the anti-graft court in February. The cases stem from the release of payments for an online occupation tracking system and a solar power installation project amounting to 57 million pesos. A 90,000 peso bail bond was recommended for each of the graft cases against the two. Bautista was Quezon City Mayor from years 2010 to 2019.
The U.S. is looking to invest $100 million for infrastructure in 9 EDCA sites in the Philippines. Katrina Domingo now on the line for more details. Kat?
Hi, Ron. The United States is expecting to allocate at least $100 million for the development of infrastructure in the 9 Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement sites in the Philippines. That's according to U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin, who gave that remark during a press conference in Washington after the Philippines and the U.S. held its 2+2 ministerial meeting for the first time in 7 years. Austin says that the U.S. is proud of the investments that they are making and that by the end of fiscal year 2023, they expect to have allocated more than $100 million in infrastructure investments at the new and existing EDCA sites here in the country. He says those investments will help spur job creation and economic growth in local Philippine communities. Now, Ron, Austin did not elaborate on what would be built in Philippine military camps where American troops would be able to access, but he noted that the two countries are also committed to swiftly finalize the U.S.-Philippines bilateral defense guidelines, which will chart the vision for alliance cooperation across all operational domains, including space and cyberspace. Austin says that in the face of coercion and gray zone aggression, he and Philippine the Department of National Defense Officer in Charge Carlito Galvez Jr. have agreed to redouble their efforts to strengthen the combined ability to resist armed attacks by modernizing both countries' armed forces. He also says that they discuss near-term plans to complete a security sector assistance roadmap to support the delivery of priority defense platforms over the next 5 to 10 years, and that would include radars and manned aerial systems, military transport aircraft, and coastal and air defense systems. He says that they are also building some 500 defense engagements that both militaries would conduct each year, and that they are forging new ties between militaries to ensure that there would be an expansion of cooperation. Ron.
That story from Katrina Domingo. Thanks, Kat.